Back for the final time of this weekend in downtown Mankato, Dan McCarger and myself, Don Westfall. Two pretty good hockey contests for the home team this weekend. They get the 6-1 win last night. They get a 4-0 win tonight. The shutout there for Dryden McKay. You go into the weekend, you know you need 6 points. It doesn't always have to be flashy. And I think for me, one of the big takeaways is, you know, the Mavericks never, even both nights, dominant in the first period, only had the 1-0 lead, stayed with the game plan. But you're just the disparity in the scoring for a while. You know, it was your top guys, Michaelis, maybe you got, well, an assist last night, but doesn't get a goal on the weekend. But you're starting to see, and you mentioned a few times during the weekend, all the way down to the fourth line. There's just that kind of depth role in the four lines is a really good spot to be in this deep into the season.
There's no question about that. How dominant were the Mavericks? These games were tied at zero, and that's it all weekend long. The Mavericks had the lead otherwise the rest of the entire weekend, and that's something that's hard to do in college hockey nowadays. And you need the 6 points. You go out and get the 6 points. These are points that matter just as much as wins against the top teams in the conference. But those losses, if you lose to a team like this, they can really hurt you for pairwise purposes. But the Mavericks just seem to come up and check every box every weekend long, and they did it again.
Mavericks last night get an early 1-0 lead that they took into the second period of play. Same thing happened again here tonight. Last night it was Hukinson with the goal, but tonight, just a couple minutes in the first period, as we get into the highlights, you're going to see a goal by Chris Van Oshaw.
Chris Van Oshaw with his second in two games at 2:34 from Napravnik, Julian Napravnik's 12th assist of the year. 1-0 Mavericks after one period of play. Jake Jaremko, with just a lucky break, the goaltender made a big mistake behind the net, and he finishes it. His fourth of the season at 2:12 makes it 2-0 Mavericks. Here's Julian Napravnik, his seventh of the season from Andy Carroll and Jack McNeely at 13:23, the second period, 3-0 Mavericks. And then the final one of the night is Josh French, who was the player of the game, the number one star of the game for Dallas Jurads, even strength at 19:09. And that is your final score, 4-0 for the Mavericks. Game summary, shots on goal 35-12. Attempted shots 83-34. You see the blocked shots there. Mavericks 1-for-5 on the power play, and they win the faceoff battle 35-26 tonight. Out-of-town scores, Lake Superior State with a win over Ferris tonight. It's Northern Michigan beating Bowling Green 3-2. The Gophers beat Michigan, so they split for the weekend. St. Cloud with a sweep of Miami, winning 5-0. UMD and Colorado College split this weekend. UMD wins 6-0 tonight. And Denver leading North Dakota 1-0 in the second period. Don, those are the new updated standings in the WCHA.
Mavericks 3 series left, but Dan, to have an 11-point lead this deep into the season, it's not a done deal yet, but the Mavericks,
it's pretty close.
The fact is, they do have, as Coach Hastings just indicated, they do have two very tough road tests. The Tufts, obviously, Michigan Tech playing better hockey, always tough during Winter Carnival. And those trips, those long trips to Alaska, you can't really take anything for granted when you make that trip.
But what you look at is, if you just get splits the rest of the year, it's almost impossible for anybody to catch you. Mm-hmm. As long as you don't get swept, and we've seen the Mavericks just don't get swept. If they can just get a split in some of these series, they're fine.
They'll be fine on the road, and they'll be fine when we see them again here, and that'll be about a month from now.
It'll be March.
It will be March 1st, believe it or not, before we're back home again, but nonetheless, that's what the calendar tells us. And so, again, the Mavericks with a couple road tests. They do have the off weekend coming up in the middle of February, but we're back here in a Maverick hockey weekend. March 1st and 2nd, the Mavericks close out the regular season, hopefully with a chance to celebrate the regular season championship, as the Beavers from Bemidji State will come down to take on the in-state rival. And then we also know that the Mavericks will be home the first weekend of the playoffs, at least potentially 4 straight weekends of hockey. We'll be looking forward to that. We'd love to see you in the building, but for those of you that can't make it, we'll see you again in March as we return with more Maverick Hockey Weekend action here on Charter Communication and on Flow Hockey TV. We'll close out the broadcast tonight with one more reminder. Our final score tonight, it was the Mavericks 4-0 win over Alabama Huntsville. For Dan McCarger, Don Westfall, and the students from Bethany Lutheran College, we thank you for watching. We will see you on March 1st.